बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ उमैरा सईद, लेक्चर इंग्लिश टाइम इंस्टीट्यूट पाकिस्तान, एंड द टॉपिक विच आई हैव लाइन अप टू डिस्कस टुडे इज़ द रिसर्च प्रपोजल। एज फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिसाइडेड दैट एंड टेकिंग अ सीरीज ऑफ डिलीवरिंग द लेक्चर्स अबाउट द रिसर्च, इन द प्रीवियस वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रिसर्च एंड इट्स टाइप, एंड लेटर ऑन वी डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू गिव द साइटेशन एंड देयर आर द वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स वी डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स। एंड टुडे लेट्स डाइव स्ट्रेट and discuss that how to prepare the research proposal. The word is very much explicit and obvious when you look at this research. As in the previous lectures we discussed that research is that something has been searched out and you are repeatedly searching out the same thing, like you are citing, you are researching and diving into the same ocean of knowledge and find, dig out and bring out something new out of it. As very clearly I told you that if it is a research, your contribution will be equal to this nib. It means that you are putting a little drop into an ocean, nothing will be new, but your addition will be not the lion's share, but your contribution will be equal to something that can be understandable and comprehensible by other researchers, and you may give a new or you may open the new avenues to the upcoming or the new researchers. Proposal, when you sketch out something, when you present something, when you give the blueprint, when you give the shortest trailer that what you are going to do in your dissertation. So presenting the proposal, presenting the synopsis before your thesis is very much important. Proposal can be replaced with another word, and that is the synopsis. Synopsis means the shortest summary of what you have done in your research, or what you are going to be done in your thesis. And after the approval of this synopsis, like it is a kind of a passport or a green card, like if your synopsis is approved that what you are going to research in your thesis, then your research will be started. So the approval of the synopsis and the research proposal is very much important with the from the supervisor's point of view. So let me be very clear, many of you will be very much confused, like many of the people come to me and said that what is the difference between the research proposal and synopsis, both are the same thing, but like it is the two names of a single thing, you may call it the research proposal, you may call it the research synopsis. So what are the main components while writing the research proposal? Here I have written it. Number one is the title. After completion of your coursework, you have been directed and suggested to write down a thesis, and it is your choice. Either you want to go for the research or you want to study another course, and I would suggest every one of you to go for the research, because research will help you to study more, to know more, to dig out more out of which you cannot understand in of your coursework. So something new will become out of you, and something different you may bring into the literary field. Because I am the student of literature and you all are the students of computer science, maybe from the medical field, your directions and your aspects of doing research will be entirely different from the way the literary people or the students of literature go for the research. The number one is the title. The title should be very much important. Title, actually there must be terseness. The title must be very captivating. Title must endorse what you are going to write inside the paper. So if I tell you that the one of the thesis which I attempted in 2007, that was the physical violence against women and the comparative analysis of two leading newspaper of Pakistan from 2007 to 2010. So this was my research title. The title was captivating, like the particularly I was dealing with the physical violence, and on the other hand I was making the comparative analysis of two leading newspapers of Pakistan. Number two thesis which I done is the transhumanism in the Stranger in the Strange Land. Like no, I have taken one novel, and now I am finding out the transhumanism or the advancement of humanity was another. The third which I learned was about the psychological disturbance or psychological evolution in the yellow wallpaper by the Charlotte Perkins. So why I am telling you, it is not that I am boasting about my knowledge here. I am telling you that sometimes the title is very much important. Title shows that what you are going to indict inside the papers. Title must be captivating. The one thing which attracts the people is the title. Like many of you watch the movie which names attract you, many of you watches the drama which drama's title attracts you, or the OST like original soundtrack attracts you. Many of you read the books whose title, whose background attracts you. Same as the thesis which has been attracted by the researchers is one which title should be attractive. Number two, the title must not be lengthy. Like it can be 50 to 20 words, but not more than that. It can be 15 to 20 words, and all the verbs, the linking verbs can be is included. Even the name of the novel or the topic which you have suggested will be included in it. So the title must not be more than 15 to 20 words. If it has exceed, it will not be a title. It will be a shortest paragraph. So the title, it must be like this. Number two is the background of the rationale. Now the most important thing is many of you have not been trained about doing the research, and pathetically in South Asia, even in half of the world, the people are not doing research. They are just copy pasting the other person's work. As in the previous when we were discussing the plagiarism, I told you that the stealing the other person's work is very much common nowadays. The people used to hire the person so that they may go, so they may do their research on their behalf. But that must be condemned by every supervisor, even at my level as well. I used to condemn the copy paste. I think that one must know that what he is going to research. We are not habitual of reading the books, we are not habitual of reading the text. The most important thing if you want to go for the original research is to read something, to read the novel, to read the original text, and then make understand the background that what they are going to suggest. So the background of your research is very much important. Background means that how many researchers have conducted research on this topic. Like you are the student of physiotherapy or the computer science or chemistry, if you are going to synthesize something or bring out some changes or want to produce some new direction of an exercise, you must know that how the previous lectures or how the previous researchers have dealt with this topic and what you are going to progress for. So your academic proliferation depends upon your approach towards something. So this is the background of the topic is very much important. If I am researching on the Toni Morrison, if I am researching on the Beckons, if I am working on the Plateaus, or suppose if I am working on an other novel of so there are so many other novels from on which we can work. You must know the work of their background of their work, that on which aspect they have discussed or dealt the novels or the topics. The research gap, dear students, it is so, I am so perplexed to tell you, and sometimes I am so luminous to know that people have no idea that what actually the research gap is. Research gap means, suppose you are working on one aspect, you must know that on which previous aspects this work has been dealt with. If I am working with the one novelist and I am fetching out the symbolism out of that novel, so I must know that many other researchers in some Europe or in some Australia, they have dealt this novel from the feminist point of view, from the Marxist point of view, from the African point of view, from the black feminist point of view. And if I am bringing out the symbolism, that is something new. It means that if you are doing research on one, suppose if you are doing research on one topic, many of the researchers will have done with this, with this, with this and this, and now this is the new aspect you are going to discuss. This is called research gap. And while doing the research gap, the finding research gap is very much important. You may search out the different research engines to find out that either this work have been done or not. So this is the research gap. When you will go for the dissertation or submitting your synopsis, this research gap will be asked. When you will go for your defense of your synopsis and the thesis as well. theoretical framework in the literary field, in the field of literature, that theory is very much important. Like suppose if you have taken if you stood some psychology course and if you are student of a physiotherapy, if you have taken your research, if you have taken the title, if you have taken a topic, then you must know that on which theory you may work on it. Theory is like a base, like this is the base and you are going to construct your building of research on that theoretical framework, because theory will give you the different postulate or different, it will provide you the direction of understanding of constructing the building. The theoretical framework or the research framework, research mechanism is incomplete without having a complete grip or hands on the theory. The significance of the study. Significance means that what is the importance of your study, what changes will you bring, what is newness in your work, what novelty will you bring out in your work, why should one be the your supervisor, why should we focus on your research, why your research must be published, why this research going to bring evolution or changes or the blast in the field of the research. Like no one can bring the blast, but how your research can be different from the other people work shows the significance of the study. We have three types of the researches: qualitative, quantitative and the mixed. And nowadays the mixed research is very much famous and the popular, and the, you have to find out that what significance will you bring out with your research work. So this is the significance of the study. The next is the research questions. For the students of the science it will be hypothesis, and for the students of literature it will be the research questions. The students research question means that now these are the two things you are going to find out. The one thing is limitation of your study. Limitation means if you have taken a book and now you are placing some kind of an a barriers and some kind of an a deterrence, that this is the aspect on which you discuss, otherwise the rest of the thing you will not discuss. So this is called the delimitation of your study. So you have to limit your scope while researching, because if you take a book and if you start researching on it, it would be difficult for you to wrap up, because a single line in a literature can be seen with the different things. It is said by a famous researcher that the book is one and the readers are thousands. The book is one and the views are thousands. The book is one and the aspects are the thousand. The book is the one and the thoughts are thousand. It means that when you look one thing, you may are looking from the one direction, the other people is looking from another direction. So delimitation will help you to wrap up your discussion at the end of the thesis. Research question is like an hypothesis, that this is the book I have chosen and I will try to find out or justify it. Like suppose if I have taken the novel Paradise by Toni Morrison, and if I am going to apply the theory of North of Fry, theory of symbolism, or the methodology is the motive, then I try to find out that which motives have been applied by the Toni Morrison in her novel. So the theory will be Fry's theory and the building will be the paradise, and the limitation will be symbolism, and the research question will be that how these symbolic interpretation is being done by the Toni Morrison in her novel Paradise. The next is the objectives. Objective means aims. If you have two objectives, your research question will be two for the student of literature. If you have three objectives, your research questions will be three. But if you are going to prepare your hypothesis in the scientific study will be one. And it depends upon the direction of your supervisor that how many objectives he wants to bring or draw out of your research work. Plagiarism we have discussed, that the copy pasting is not allowed. You may not steal other person's work. You may take the other person's work as a reference. You may quote another person's references. You may take and help from the page 64 out of any of the book, but you cannot write down the same sentences because of some copyright aspects as well. And this is the plagiarism may also help you to bring out some new, and the plagiarism on the basis of plagiarism your work can be rejected at the nib of an author. So try to avoid the copy paste. Paraphrase is one of aspect which is being very much appreciable by the supervisors as well. You may paraphrase, rephrase, rewrite, reproduce, but the most important thing is that you must know and you must have an understanding that what actually the research is. Written on the citation. When you, if you want to avoid this plagiarism, the citation is very important. If you are taking the references from any book or the research paper or from any of the thesis, you may quote a complete references from APA and MLA. These are the two formats of writing the thesis. One is the APA, second is the MLA. And APA, American Psychological Association. This APA format for writing research in Pakistan is being approved by ACC. So you have to follow the APA style rather than following the MLA. So we either you are the students of science or the literature, the student of medical or the student of engineering. If you are going for the research, your format of writing the research will be APA. Then at the end, in the student, as a student of literature, we used to conclude, like it has been very difficult to conclude something because maybe the author mind is different and the my ideologies and my beliefs are different, but better is to give the references. You may give the suggestions, but you may not conclude any topic, because conclude means that now you are closing the chapter and you are slamming the door for the rest of the researchers. You may give the suggestions, but you may not conclude any of the topic. So my dear student, this was my little effort about the research proposal. I hope that you would have now hands on over the research, and after few years here, when you will write your research paper or some publications, it will help you a lot. Remember me in your prayers. See you with the next lecture. Take care. Allah Hafiz.